So, dear friends, students, my dear colleagues and teachers, the purpose of starting this particular YouTube channel is for helping students and practitioners. If you like the video, please subscribe it, share it with your friends, and please don't forget to hit the bell. So we are all here. We are all here on this platform because of this noble person, Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, founder of homeopathy. This is a blank slide that I am showing to you. The purpose of this is, I have a small incident to tell you. So once there was a BHMS undergraduate student who had developed conjunctivitis, for which he sought help from a postgraduate student. So the postgraduate student took the case and he prescribed some medicine, but the problem did not get solved, and he changed the medicine, repeated the medicine, but the problem still remained. So the postgraduate student, he took this particular student suffering with conjunctivitis to one of his teachers. The teacher looked into the eyes of the student and a sentence came telling that you have a lot of MRSA in your eyes, and the student got relief from his symptoms within a day by MRSA 200. Now, my dear friends, here, what difference you find between the teacher and a postgraduate student? Because the postgraduate student has read Marksol in his undergraduation. The difference that you can find is the experience that the teacher is having. So here, the teacher knows more, so he can see more. So for this, let us do a small experiment. I will show you an image. Now, can you tell me what is this image? So take a few seconds, just see this image, and whenever I have shown this image to people of different age groups, some people have noticed it as a tree, somebody recognizes it as a tree without leaves, somebody tells it as a dried leaf, but I have even found some students, they tell that there are faces of different people in this. And still, when I asked some other people, they could find the faces of the leaders of our nation. So my dear friends, what we find here is the same picture being noticed by different people answer differently, and all are right. There is nobody who is wrong here. A child sees, he finds it as a tree. Another person finds it as a dry tree. So what we come to know after this small experiment is that if you know more, you can see more. So my dear friends, if you want to see Marksol in the eyes of your patient, you should know more so that you can see more. So here, it is only an attempt to sensitize everyone towards the study of homeopathic metramedica. So in aphorism 105, Hahnemann tells, I am not going to read the whole sentences, but what Hahnemann wants everybody is to know the knowledge of the instruments intended for the cure of natural diseases, and among them, you are going to select only one for treating the sick. So the artificial disease knowledge developed by proving the drugs on healthy human being should be known and should be applied in treating the sick by selecting a single remedy. So this is where Hahnemann tells that we should individualize. So we should individualize the drug and also individualize the sick. Now going to aphorism 106. So Hahnemann says that the pathogenetic effect of several medicines should be known. That is, the alterations that they have produced while proving on a healthy individual. So that is what we call it as artificial disease. Now going to the another aphorism, in aphorism 118. So here he tells that medicines exhibit peculiar actions on the human frame, which are not produced in exactly the same manner by any other medicinal substance of a different kind. So what we come to know here is that there are no two medicines which are alike, and each medicine produces peculiar actions which is unique to itself. Now going to in aphorism 120, Hanuman says that the experiments conducted on healthy human being by the drugs should be distinguished among themselves for a correct selection for the greater purpose of treating the sick, so that health is permanently restored. Now, Dr. Kent says that there is no royal road to a perfect understanding of homeopathic Matra Medica. So if we want one method that you read Matra Medica in this way and you will be perfect in it, it is highly impossible, because we don't have any royal road to understand the subject called as homeopathic Matra Medica. Now, Matra Medica can be learned, cannot be memorized. I have seen several students, especially freshers who join second batch HMS, and when the exam is there, suddenly they read 10 drugs before the day of the exam, and the next day morning everything is confused. While reading Matra Medica appears to be very easy, but when you want to apply it, you will be confused. So Matra Medica cannot be memorized, it can only be learned. So there are several ways to learn the subject Matra Medica. So let us try to know what are the different ways of studying homeopathic Matra Medica. So when homeopathy came into existence, there were wonderful teachers who taught Matra Medica by lecture method. So whatever classes you attend in the colleges, that is nothing but lecture method. So earlier, these lectures were noted down by the students, and those notes were assembled and they were formed in the form of a book. So we are having several books in the form of lectures, that is lectures on clinical Matra Medica in family order by E.A. Farrington. Then the common book that we use in day-to-day life is lectures on homeopathic Matra Medica by Dr. J.T. Kent. Then lectures on Matra Medica by Carol Denham. So now, here is another method called as group discussion method. So my dear friends, this is the one which we don't do. So even the students, they study the drugs and they just directly want to go into the exam and write, or want to go into over the viva and give the answers. But the best method to remember is when you are sitting across a table with a cup of tea, please try to communicate with your friends regarding what you have read, what drugs you have read, and ask what they have read. Try to know what you have missed. Try to know what he has told which you have not recollected. So this is the problem which it can be solved in learning Matra Medica and remembering it in a better way. Group discussion is one of the best way to recollect Matra Medica. Now coming to another method, that is anatomical schematic method. Here the books of Matra Medica have been written in anatomical schematic method. So by writing in an anatomical schematic method, you will not forget to miss any system. You will recollect what symptoms this system has produced. So there were books written on anatomical schematic method. So one is Matra Medica Pura by Dr. Hanuman himself. Then we have the guiding symptoms of our Matra Medica by Herring. Then we have Encyclopedia of Pure Matra Medica by Alan T.F. A Dictionary of Practical Matra Medica by Lippe. Handbook of Matra Medica and Homeopathic Therapeutics by Alan T.F. So now another method that is very, very important, that is keynote method. So you might have heard the word key. You are having a big lock for your house. and that big lock can be opened by a very small key. So this key opens up the full case many times. This key makes you to recognize the particular drug. The key symptom in a patient makes you to recognize the drug which suits to this particular patient. So now let us do another experiment here, because we remember when we involve ourselves. So when we involve ourselves, when we start thinking. So I will show you an image and I want you to recognize the person. So here is the image. So can you recognize who this person is? So whenever I have shown this image to the many of the students, they have easily recognized. And I think you have also having the same person in your mind, and the person is none other than Mahatma Gandhi. So I have shown this image for many batches, more than 8 years I think. I have shown this image to all the batches whenever I am teaching this particular topic, and everybody has recognized. Some people answered immediately, some people answered after taking a few minutes, but everybody answered. But unfortunately, there was a batch of I think 10 to 15 students who could not recognize this particular image, and they could not tell that it is Mahatma Gandhi. So it was my plan became a flop. So I should have an idea so that again these people can understand why, what is the key and what is its importance. So immediately I got another image in my mind, and I drew this particular image on the blackboard, and immediately I got the answer, and also you might have got the answer, that it is nothing but Lord Venkateshwara. If I ask you to draw an image of Lord Venkateshwara, you cannot draw an image of Lord Venkateshwara without this particular symbol. This particular symbol itself is enough that it is Lord Venkateshwara. If you draw a beautiful statue of Lord Venkateshwara and if you don't put this symbol, recognizing that it is Lord Venkateshwara is very, very difficult. So this is the key. So the key unlocks the whole image of the individual. The key unlocks the whole image of a drug. So there are several authors who have written books of Metramedica in the form of keynotes. So one is Keynotes of Leading Remedies by Allen, which is a common book. I suggest all the students, even the practitioners, to keep one in one pocket Allen's keynote and in another pocket Organon of Medicine. So both are very small books, but they are very, very important books. Another book that we have is A Primer of Metramedica by Allen T.F. Then A Synoptic Key to Metramedica by Bogar C.M. I suggest everybody should go through this book, because C.M. Bogar is considered to be very miser in using the words. A small word means a big sentence. A small word many times means a big paragraph by C.M. Bogar. We have Characteristic Metramedica by W.H. Burt. And we have Keynotes and Redline Symptoms of Metramedica by Lippe. So now coming to the fifth way of studying, that is picture type of study. Here, by reading these books or by understanding the drug in this manner, we develop an image of the drug substance, or we develop the image of a sick individual. So that is what is picture type of study. So this type of presentation has been given by several authors. So one among them is commonest book that we use is Lectures on Homeopathic Metramedica by J.T. Kent. Then Homeopathic Drug Pictures by Tyler. Then Homeopathic Metramedica of Graphical Drug Pictures and Clinical Comments by Pulford. So now another method of studying is study on the basis of miasms. Medicines can be studied by dividing symptoms according to miasms. So when a Hanuman tried to find the cause of the disease, he found that there is a fundamental cause for which he called as miasms, which manifests in three different ways. And these three different ways, he called it as Sora, Psychosis and Syphilis. So now there are drugs which are having prominent psoric symptoms. There are drugs which are having prominent psychotic symptoms. There are drugs which are having prominent syphilitic symptoms. So now, many of you might have gone through the drugs which are prominently psoric, psychotic, syphilitic. So let us try to know one of that. So can you name a remedy which is prominently psoric? So if you have got rightly in your mind, so that is sulfur. Can you now again think about a drug which is prominently psychotic? So that is, again, if you have got in your mind the right remedy, I think it is Thuja occidentalis. Similarly, can you get into your mind a syphilitic drug? A syphilitic drug which is having destruction in it, and that is nothing but Merck-Sol. So now another method of study is therapeutic method. My dear friends, Mater Medica is the only subject which is having so many methods of study. There are so many difficult subjects you have gone through: anatomy, physiology, pathology, surgery. They don't have all these methods, because while reading those subjects, you have little difficulty, but you will not forget them later. But Mater Medica, when you are reading, it appears very simple, but when you want to recollect it, you will get confused, or you will feel as if you have read it somewhere. You will sometimes remember the name of the remedy, you will not remember the symptoms. If you know the symptoms, you will not remember which remedy this particular symptoms belong. So another method that we have is therapeutic method. So here, the drugs which are having common features similar to a particular disease are grouped under it. So that is the therapeutic method. So if we have a disease name, then we will get into mind those many drugs which have produced similar manifestations of that particular disease. And there are several books, my dear friends, which you can go through. That is Homeopathic Therapeutics by Lilienthal, and Practical Homeopathic Therapeutics by Dewey. Now another method that we can study is by physiological method. Here the action of the drugs, especially in the crude forms, have been producing physiological changes in the provers. So we are having physiological symptoms in this particular books, which have been written by Dr. Copperthwaite. Then we are having Physiological Mater Medica by William Burt, a Manual of Pharmacodynamics by Richard Hooks, and Characteristic Mater Medica by Das Gupta. Now, my dear friends, here we come across a very important study, that is group study. So Mater Medica subject is very vast. It is having so many remedies, and each remedy is having so many symptoms. So remembering each remedy becomes very difficult. So this is the place where group study helps you a lot. So group study, it includes study of similar drugs. So the drugs which are having similar characteristic features or similar manifestations, you read them, compare with each other, and that is how we can study. Then study the drugs which are related in some definite way. For example, kingdom study, animal kingdom, plant kingdom, mineral kingdom. So what are the common features that animals are having? What are the common features that plants are having? What are the common features that minerals are having? And now family study. So in plant kingdom, we are having so many families, and studying the drugs in a particular family will make study of the drugs easier and remembering them better. Now we are having several books here. One is Homeopathic and Minerals by John Shorten. So here you are having another book, that is Textbook of Homeopathic Mater Medica by Otto Lesser. Then Group Study in Homeopathic Mater Medica with Quick Review Flowcharts by Dr. J.D. Patil. Group Study Analysis of Homeopathic Mater Medica by Dr. Dadfale. Homeopathy and Homeopathic Prescribing by Harvey Farrington. So these are the books, my dear friends, where you will get group study, and you can remember the drugs in that particular group better And even if you have not read one particular drug in that particular group, have read other drugs and you know the common features of this one, you can apply that particular knowledge even the drug to which you have not read. But however, individualization is very, very important in homeopathy. And another book that we are having very important is Universal Mineral Matter Medica by Ramesh D. Jain. So now, still simplifying the groups, we can make a chart like this, that is, you can go on viewing it every day so that you can remember the common features. Here we are having carbons, the common mental general symptoms, the common physical general symptoms, therapeutic value of the carbons, its diathesis, modalities, its constitution, relationship. So this will make you to remember the whole carbons in a gist and will help you to generalize the symptoms of carbons and making the remembering easy. Now Dr. Rajan Sankaran says he has observed certain common features in the various kingdoms, and he has come to a conclusion through his observations and even by implementing it on treating the sick. So he has found that plant kingdoms are having more of sensitivity. Then animal kingdom, the features that they manifest are having that are of survival, that is of hierarchy, then that is of competitiveness. And when we come to the minerals, it is observed that there is a form of manifestation in the form of structure in the minerals. Now, let us take one example of study by Rajan Sankaran, one of the family, that is Anacardiaceae. If we take, he has found that there is a sensation which is very common for this particular family, is a sensation as if caught, a stiff sensation, stuck sensation, as if there is a cramp, so it is unable to move. And the passive reaction is, that is, he is paralyzed, he is immobile, he is unable to move. Now, what is the active reaction for this particular passive reaction is that he is aggravated by sitting in the house. He is aggravated first motion, and how he compensates is he always wants to move. So now you can find that Rostox, he feels better by moving. He is aggravated by rest, amelioration by continued motion. So that is, it belongs to Anacardiaceae family, and even other drugs of Anacardiaceae family, they are having this particular stuck like sensation. Even Anacardium orientale, you are having that as a sensation as if a ball, as if something is stuck. So that is what is the observation of Dr. Rajan Sankaran. John Shelton has found that calciums, they will be worried about what others will say about him, delusions that others will see his confusion, sensitive to criticism, insecure feeling, fear of loss, fear of poverty, fear of disease. There is anticipatory fear, protection by withdrawal or building a wall. So they always wants to be protected, so because of this particular fear. So these are the common features which calciums are having. So this is makes remembering a group of drugs belonging to particular mineral which are common. So here we are having another book, that is by Dr. Ramesh D. Jain, Universal Matter Medica with Pharmacodynamics. So where he attempts to correlate and derive the medicines based on periodic table and relate it with homeopathic matter medica. So merits of group study. So when we are having when we are studying so many drugs in a particular group, definitely there are certain merits. That is, it gives every remedy its basic theme. So as we took some example as Anacardiaceae, the stuck feeling, it is common in all the drugs, and it offers benefit to mental and physical general level. So the general symptoms are common in this particular group. Enhance the knowledge of remedies that are already well known in certain areas. So whatever drugs we know, and when we study it along with the group, it enhances the knowledge, and it helps to predict the homeopathic picture of unknown remedies. So if there is another drug which is there and it is not yet proved, or it is partially proved, so this study of the group also helps in applying it on that particular drug. and it also helps in forming combination drugs for some people. But however, it is not suggested. That is, we need to prescribe individually. So there are certain demerits of group study. It is not the only way, that is, of prescribing. So there are so many other ways of prescribing, and in order to get good results, one must be expert in this aspect. So this is possible only by experienced people, because they are the people who can study. They have studied by group wise, and they can differentiate the drugs with each other and making prescription possible. So it is the experienced people who can use this particular method. And as we study at these groups, it will not suggest an individual drug. Okay. So another method that we have is studying on the basis of proving. So homeopathic drugs have been proved on healthy human beings, and it was Hanuman who proved the drugs for the first time. And as you know, Synconoma was the drug which was proved for the first time by Hanuman. And Hanuman wrote his proving, and he published a book called as Metra Medica Pura, where you can find the pure symptoms of the drugs proven on healthy human beings. Then we are having Condensed Metra Medica by Herring and Siddhi by Dr. Adil Chintanwala. So presently also, every 6 months, Dr. Adil Chintanwala, they conduct proving of a drug, and they are publishing in a book called as Siddhi. So now, these are the various references which has helped me in making this presentation. That is Hanuman's Organon, and Azad Rai's Scholar Manual of Homeopathic Metra Medica, Dr. Darpade's Group Study, Dr. J.D. Patil's Group Study, Borik, Khera Illustrated Cum Rhymed Metra Medica, and Dr. J.D. Patil's Gems of Homeopathic Metra Medica. So this presentation of various methods of studying Metra Medica will be continued in the next video. If you like the video, please subscribe it, share it among your friends, and please don't forget to ring the bell so that you can receive further uploadings of the exploring of homeopathic metra medica. Thank you.